question as well.
That's off topic. I'll talk about Turkey government. No, mate, listen, yeah. She's spreading false information about Islam. I'm telling her your government are terrorists.
All politics is off topic.
I am telling you.
She's spreading false information about Islam. You're getting your shit from Bukhari. You're getting your shit from Bukhari.
It's not authentic. It's not authentic.
It's not authentic.
One of the most reliable information regarding the biography and customs of Sahih Bukhari is actually rubbish. And he used another word which
and
I cannot use.
That's something we don't know.
Why are you repeating yourself every time?
Say something new.
But Muslims are quite
different.
Why? Because that is the language of mankind, in a room, and parrot each other there.
Yeah? Teach your little parrots how to talk in your own house.
Where did you get that
jacket? Why are you coming here repeating yourself every time? Answer my question, answer first! You're patching me up now. The gays like to take over Speaker's Corner.
Sure you took your medication before you come here?
Medication?
Your pan we are in this morning.
He's got medication.
Are we talking for the cameras or are you talking to a human being?
Seven actual days.
No, we're talking about why Sahih Bukhari is not considered authentic.
He's a sharmuta and his day will come.
Ibn al-Gahba.
Ibn al-Gahba, that's it.
What's Ibn al-Bakha? What's
it means son of a bitch. It means son of a bitch.
Who's
Erdogan. Erdogan.
Erdogan.
Yeah.
The Turkey president.
They got nothing to say!
He's a Turkish people. I'm talking about Erdogan and he's a Turkish people. Have some respect. I said Turkish president. No, you said Turkish people.
Have some respect. Turkish people are above you.
Have some respect. I'm talking about Erdogan.
Are you Turkish?
Turkish president.
There is a country called Turkey who is responsible for genocide.
Three genocide.
What's the third?
Two genocide.
Assyrian. Which has been responsible.
Greek genocide as well, yeah.
We got a bit of Jewish in you too.
No.
There is a country called Turkey who is responsible for the death of exodus and their persecution. Man called Muhammad who lived and died in 632.
Have you guys ever thought of like giving secularism a chance?
Maybe a few years. Put the Bible down for a good five years to see how it plays out for you. People have no problem with Muhammad. You might find yourself having a bit of fun.
Nah.
But they had a problem.
You might find yourself in hell.
Erdogan is doing where he's being inspired by his religion. I think that is just double wonderful.
Yes.
But all it tells us, in this very much broken world, people are hungry for something.
Yeah, we're waiting for Jesus to come back. We're waiting for Jesus to come back.
Is he going to save you when he comes back? When he comes back, he's going to finish your government. If you have not done that, it's going to be very bad for you. Because Jesus is going to come back.
We're going to be on Jesus' side.
Jesus is going to come back.
He's not going to break the cross. He's not going to kill the pig. He's not going to cancel the jizya.
And Jesus is going to condemn
you.
How do you know?
Oh, you're good. Are you good?
Too late for you, bruv.
Read the gospel. Whether you like it or not.
Give up the Quran.
I am with Jesus. If you're a true believer of Christ,
we're going to be on the same side.
Jesus
whether you like it or not.
You don't believe. You don't believe.
For him to give his life
you believe in Muhammad, not
therefore
Jesus.
He did give
Isa
his life
is not Jesus. You have the wrong Jesus. The wrong Jesus.
It's Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, going to come back.
The wrong Jesus.
No.
Jesus is going to come back.
Prophet, peace be upon him, or maybe police be upon him, one of them, but not for sure. police? This is all police.
Oh, police. Give me police.
The moment when you hear man called Muhammad, who has been identified as the prophet of Islam.
Why are you talking about prophet of Islam when you know nothing about our prophet?
The police.
You don't know nothing about Jesus. Let's talk about Jesus, and let's talk about any other prophet. Come on.
Why don't you want
Come on! Come on!
Why don't you want to talk about
Come on! You don't know nothing about him!
You don't know
nothing! You don't know nothing!
Why don't you tell us about him?
Tell us about him! You don't know nothing!
You don't know nothing!
Tell us about him!
That's why you don't want to talk. Okay, so talk. Have some respect! Don't demand anything from me! I don't owe you anything! I don't know you anything! I don't need to speak to you! I don't need to speak to you!
She
keeps raising it. I keep Do you want to talk on the level? Do you want to talk on the level? Do you want to have an on the level conversation with me? Are you going to disrespect me in a minute? Are you going to talk to. Look! She can't answer this simple question. If I can ask anybody this question, they should be able to answer yes or no. Yes or no. I will answer yes or no to you if you answer yes or no to me. I know you don't have any answers for me. Yeah? If you're going to ask something, have some respect. If you actually want to know something, you want to learn something, you ask it properly. Yeah? Don't demand! No! What is she doing? What is she doing? Look, I can hear you! I can hear you! Don't touch! Don't touch!
Back up! What are you
going
to do?
Who is this guy?
Back up!
Who is this guy?
Back up!
And I stand calm.
Back up!
Why are you touching me? Who are you touching? Who are you touching? Back up what? Back up what? Back up what? Touch me! Touch me! Touch me!
Back up!
Touch me! Touch me!
It is amazing. Muhammad is so untouchable. Muslims don't even want to teach us about Muhammad because they are ashamed of their prophet.
I don't want
that their prophet climbed the top of a child. They are ashamed.
You got something to say?
Yeah, just back up. That's what I've got to say.
Who are you to tell me to back up? Who are you to tell me to back up? Who am I talking to here? How many people am I talking to here? How many cameras are here? Yeah, ask, answer the question. Answer the question. Answer the question.
Can we just spread a little bit?
Thank you, everyone.
This group is far bigger than six.
Thank you, everybody.
We need to spread out.
Spread out.
We're going to walk away from this person. We're going to walk away from him. Hey, Hatu.
Guys, get your backpacks. Please keep it as a group.
Simple question was
this.
Wasn't
even standing here. The camera's
spread out a little bit.
No, we're going to move over here. Move
over. Simple question.
I know you feel me.
Look how he just spoke to me.
My basic question was on Muhammad. I want to be educated. How did Muhammad, while as a 44 years old man, climb the top of a child? Sir, are you able to explain that to us?
Don't bring him in.
They don't want to pick us. They don't know about their prophet. But they couldn't answer the basic question. But the sad reality is,
your question.
There is something very much disturbing in the teachings of Islam, as well as there is something very much disturbing in the life of Muhammad. Why? What Muhammad did to women, what Muhammad did to human beings, is very dangerous. And this is the fruit of it. And you don't want to eat that fruit. You don't even want to make fruitcake from that fruit because it is not helpful to anyone at all. But all we get to see is,
there you go. Iranian way. Everyone knows what this means.
I'm used to it anyway. I've come down
here.
Get something to eat.
Alright, nice one. Thank you for your contribution, bro. Okay, wrap up.
There has been something wrong.
Where's your uncle? Where's your Iranian?
In Thank our you. Hearts, since first men and women choose to walk away from God. It's not only they walked away from God, they choose to run away from God.
Yeah.
That happened in the garden where God was walking and talking with mankind.
I'm going to tell you the entire story because I said it in about 5 minutes. It takes me about 5 minutes.
Is,
we're moving back in.
God!
No, I'm still here.
You want God, to talk, just spread out a little. Okay, right, cool.
Please, keep some space.
No, that's fine.
We're
that's
all closed in really close together. If we can just spread out a little bit, problem solved, okay?
Thank you. That son who holds all the universe with the power of his world. That son who says, I am the Lamb of God who is going to give up his life for you. And that son gives his life on the cross for people like me, people like him, and one of the first is
she knows me now,
Muhammad, who intentionally ran away from him.
Never met me or had a conversation with me.
The Son of God, the Lamb of God, gave himself on the cross for us. Yeah. And magic, miracle is, he did not stay dead in the grave, he conquered the dead.
Yes.
On the third day, he is risen. On the third day, people checked out and that grave is empty. Why? Because we see that grave is empty, we know people like us who deserves nothing, people like us who deserves no life, can have life in Christ, can have life with God. Why? Because eternal Son of God gave himself on the cross for people like me, people like him,
keep lying,
Muhammad, and even for the police. Without color boundary, without age boundary, without gender boundary,
nothing.
Lord Jesus Christ, with his death and his resurrection, offers us to be his.
We're his.
This place which we live and which we see actually urgently hunting for God.
Yeah.
While people are running away from God, God did not run away from us.
Son
came into the world, lived among us, so that we can live in the bosom of the Father.
What about your Turkish government? What about Turkish government? Tell me, please. What are you doing?
Why are you so ashamed of your prophet? Why
I'm speaking
are
about Turkish government.
So
talk about your
British
prophet. Government. Talk about
I am
your British
talking
government.
About your prophet.
No,
you freaked out from your prophet. You
what
want to
your
talk
government?
About Turkish
what about
government.
Your Turkish government.
Why are you so ashamed of it?
Our government are terrorists. Yeah.
This might be the time
from
for
ISIS.
You to give
they
Muhammad
ISIS.
Once for
they
all.
They sent fighters to Azerbaijan. They sent fighters to Libya.
As much as you can. With those shoes.
The bomb in Iraq.
As you run away,
shoes are more than your
Lamb of God will wait for you. As you run away from Muhammad, Lamb of God, Lord Jesus Christ, tells you to go to him.
Yeah.
And then he wants you. It's not only he needs you, but he wants you. He wants you to spend eternity with him. But what we see is you are so much freaked out from your prophet, you can't even answer the basic questions about him. Don't you find that disturbing?
Ask him one basic question.
What's the basic question?
Actually, let me come to the other basic question.
Okay.
Which you brought it up to our attention.
Okay. Erdogan, no?
Not Erdogan.
Okay.
We've got someone who is better than Erdogan called
Sahih Bukhari.
Sahih
Bukhari. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
ISIS is son of a bitch.
Erdogan's
a Wahhabi.
He heard from Muslims.
I'm gonna come back in like
very bad word against him. 94% Muslim world puts their eternity to that book, but Muslims today simply tells us that he's not only reliable, we need to get rid of him. Don't you find that's very disturbing?
Yeah.
As a Christian, I find that very disturbing, but Muslims are quite happy for Sahih Bukhari to not go only under the bus, but even end up in the grave.
Wow.
Very, very sad. I am sure his bones, alongside of the bones of Muhammad, is shaking.
She's still not finished talking. I gotta go in 5 minutes, yeah? If you don't wanna hear my 5 minutes, I already said it only takes 5 minutes to put her straight. Yeah? It's up to her to choose to stay on the right path. After that, I'll put her in her spot. Yeah? After that, it's up to you.
Jesus,
up!
You, sir,
they're not going to let me talk.
Tell me, how did Muhammad climb on the top of a child? Because that's
you,
not
you're finished!
Question.
You're finished!
Just ask your question.
You're finished!
Talk about the Turkish government,
finish
that's terrible.
Let's talk about your partnership.
No, talk about Erdogan.
Let's talk about that.
Talk about Erdogan.
No, 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 we don't want to talk about Erdogan.
I want to talk about Erdogan.
Why don't you want to talk about
Erdogan? You talk about the prophet every day.
You're coming to talk about every day.
Look, you had
yes,
enough
he's
practice.
A prophet.
You've
whether
had enough
you
practice.
Like it, whether you
go
like
on,
it or not,
for
he's
real.
A prophet.
Talk for real now. It's no more bullshit. Yeah? You're not going to get away with it. You're not getting away with it. Can I tell you what?
How did your prophet climb the top of a child?
No, that's Bukhari. Hey, that's
that's Bukhari.
You what?
Okay.
You what?
I didn't say that.
Did you see that? Yeah.
Climbed the top of the
how? When? When was it? Where was it?
Muhammad
where?
How?
How? When?
That's
where?
That's my question. You said you wanted to educate me.
Hey, listen. What happened to you last night? Tell me.
So answer the question.
Answer the question. You ask something hard, I'll ask you something simple. If you can answer it, I'll give you the hard answer.
Can you be kind and tell me, how did your prophet call Muhammad?
How many children, how many babies did Erdogan kill yesterday? How many babies?
They got no respect. They think I'm going to answer them, yeah? Just because they're trying to fool someone.
Don't give her the platform.
Bro, I'm not. She's finished.
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 With her.
Can you talk properly? This
the
is London.
Bruv,
don't spit on me.
Step back then. Step back then. 2 meters. 2 meters.
Whoa.
Bro, you're a funny guy, bro.
Take a step back.
I'm here. He's stepping to me.
Don't spit on me, bro.
Take a step back.
Wear a mask. Wear a mask, bruv. That's what you need to do.
Where's your mask? This is Speaker's Corner.
Okay, let's see.
Yes, there are certain things you can't wear in Speaker's Corner, but no one gets right to spit on people at Speaker's Corner.
Okay, so good.
I think that should be very basic knowledge. Spitting individuals is not acceptable.
Yeah, we could.
You asked him, go ask Hamza. Why are you asking him?
Hato, ask Hamza and Ali Dawa, he says.
Go ask Hamza, she's been dealt with.
And then your discourse who tells us there are holes in the narrative. They want us to go and find people and then ask them, tell about the holes.
Ah, the holy, the holy.
If those holes come from Masjid, where are those holes come from? Don't you find it a bit strange
a little
that
strange
Muslims
happened.
Are sending you to other Muslims to answer the question which affects their own eternity?
Yeah.
This guy's the biggest pig in history.
His brother, and then I say, brother, tell me who Jesus is. And then he says, oh no, I don't know who Jesus is. Go and ask someone else. You are responsible for your own fate. What happened to your brain? Did you not think now you are sending people to other individuals who screams out to the world there are holes in the narrative?
Holy.
Not very helpful at all.
Nothing. Some rapper words had to. Some encouraging words.
All I am curious about.
I don't come out of town.
What is it about Islam makes Muslims to be ashamed of their prophet? I am Christian. I come to Speaker's Corner as long as it's not locked down every week. I am not ashamed of Lord Jesus Christ. And my prayer that he will never be ashamed of me. Yet I know there is nothing can separate his love towards me. I can defend my God, he's defendable. But the moment Muhammad or Quran is on the question, what we see is lovely Islamism practice because followers of Islam is ashamed of their prophet.
People! You're finished, you're halas! Khatun, go home!
I might be finished!
Right.
I might be finished!
Yeah.
But the bottom line is, keep walking! Lord of Lords, Lord Jesus Christ is still on the throne! He rules and reigns! He holds all the universe with the power of his word!
Talk about
Lord Bukhari. Jesus Christ is the one who gives life to us! He is the source of life. It is Lord Jesus Christ who offers us eternal life. I might be finished. I might get it finished. And one day, Lord is going to take my breath away from me. But I know when I finish, where I am going to be.
Where?
I will be in the bosom of the Father. Amen. Because the death and resurrection of Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I might be finished, but Lord Jesus Christ is still on the throne, and He will be on that throne to the
forever and ever.
That's the word I was looking for. Praise the Lord. For eternity. People will finish. We will all leave this world because we are not belong to here. But we are belong to the bosom of the Father.
Yeah.
When we get there, we will know Lord Jesus Christ still rules and reigns, and no one can finish him.
Praise the Lord!